Welcome and thank you for joining us. This is The Spice. My name is Rotimi and I have with me. Okay, she's saying hi. That's her style. Anyway, so many things happen. But before I do that, you need to tell us your name, whether you like it or not.
Like, y'all don't know my name.
Okay, so I'm watching you for the first time.
My name is Moyo, M-O-Y-O, Moyo.
Okay, Moyo, how's your weekend? So many things happened over the weekend. And one of those things that happened was the issue of the Jegun fire, whereby many people lost their lives and so many things happened. In fact, some reports told us that the fire could not be quenched after about 17 hours.
How will it be quenched?
And as a result of that, even what actually caused that, you know what I'm talking about, as a result of vandalism, pipeline explosion and all that, that some people, because they are trying to find a way to scoop food and all that.
As much as we have to be sympathetic and all these things, it's not as if the pipeline decided to blow on its own. It was some people's activity. And this is not the first time, it's not the second time that this thing is happening. Like, it's like Nigerians, we don't learn. Or maybe human beings. So
okay.
I don't know. I think it's just...
What about thinking about poverty? You know, people often... oftentimes we think that okay if we could just get some of the food, we can resell and make money, even though it doesn't make any sense.
Maybe it's poverty. Maybe they've seen the result of the poverty.
That is it. It's a big problem.
And they've seen the results now. Maybe they are poor. They want to vandalize this thing. They want to smuggle and collect petrol. Maybe they've seen the results. What is wrong is wrong. I don't know. I don't know how people think.
Nevertheless, don't you think people should, in a way, support them? We should,
of course. We are human beings. We will still,
We are still Nigerians.
We will still help them. But we don't create problem in the first place that you'll not be looking for solution for. Believe it.
And something like that, something related to that, happened in the past. Okay, Benue. Benue, yes.
Okay.
A trailer, a petrol tanker was actually, you know, heading to a place somewhere, probably to Makurdi and all that. And, you know, there was an accident and people, the villagers just came around to scoop, I'm telling you. And that's how they got burnt.
You see what I'm saying? I don't know, the knowledge that I had when I was growing up, once you see fuel or something, even spilling on the road you run away. But these days, it's the opposite to God will help us.
And before we leave that, you know, there's this issue about when things are happening like that, people usually don't take actions. Now, what they want to do, the kind of action they take is to start taking pictures, start taking videos and all that, instead of calling like 767-112 so that
it's the age that we are. There's really I don't think there's anything anybody can do about it, and it's going to get worse as the years and times go by.
Okay, let's just say that's the effect of technology anyway. But that's another kettle of fish some other time. Okay, and that takes us to Kozagbara, you know that song very well. And somebody has actually reacted talking about
our daddy Gio,
absolutely. And people are saying that he's actually referring to the pastor.
What is people are saying? He said he wants to address an issue.
He did not mention anybody's name.
He said he wants to address an issue based on what has been happening. The thing that has been happening is the fact that people have been accusing the Koza Fatoyinbo of rape. And Baba is addressing issue of rape. He's just saying this is common sense. He doesn't need deep thinking. It's common sense.
But let's be sincere. That's not the only rape issue that has happened.
That's the viral rape issue that has happened.
That's the one that has
hit the church hard. That's the one that PFN and CAN and they are trying to be very guided and very distinct with their words so that they don't throw stone on anybody, but at the same time trying to distinct.
And you know something that caught my attention was that statement that when a lady accuses you of something, nobody will listen to you. In fact, nobody will believe you. And I know.
No, the thing depends. It's not really about a lady. It's about the person, as in who the person is, who the lady has turned out to be before this thing happened. Now, if a child accuses you of something, it's not the same gravity as when an adult accuses you of something.
Okay.
Now, if somebody that is known to be a liar accuses you of something, it's not the same gravity as someone who has very high integrity,
okay.
who has
Do
very...
Do we call this a natural thing? That naturally, when a lady talks about something, people usually believe.
That's what I'm still trying to address.
Okay.
Like, it's not about, this is, it's not even gender related now. It is what the person has carved for themselves, what the person has able to build, the personality that, for instance, if I'm not known to be a liar and I come out to say something, there's tendency for more people to believe,
okay.
as opposed to people that already know, this one she can. It's a different thing. Now, when somebody that doesn't talk, comes out to say something, and not just anything, something that is huge, people would pay attention, because the next thing they would think is like, and this person doesn't
and
talk.
And it doesn't matter whether you're old or you're young.
No.
Any young girl can come up. So ministers, just like Baba said, okay, be careful and all of that. He was actually referring to ministers. Young and young minister, so to speak.
So yes. The person we're talking about is not a young minister, it's his old minister.
Okay, but it's one of those things. It's one of those things. Anyway, so and some other things happened. The Copa America, of course, Brazil actually won.
That was
the score was 3-1.
Brazil's winning is not the thing. The major distinct for me is the fight that third place match, Chile and
and Peru, right?
No. Argentina and who did they play? Ooh, I can't remember.
Okay.
But so the two captains sent off, that's Messi and the other guy. And you know, it became a war again on Twitter, you know, your goats receives red card, you know, and I don't know, the red card scenario was a little bit too, the referee was just very
and funny. Usually there's something about being popular, you know, when you're famous, you're a known
in
a particular field and all, so whatever happens to you sometimes people will definitely debate and talk about it, okay, whether it's right or not right and all of that. And I'm talking about that Copa America, since 2007 Brazil has not lifted that cup, so to speak. And you know, it's one of those. Another one that came up recently is the issue of the Women World Cup. Yes, that takes me back to gender issues, because I read a report where the spokeswoman for that team, USA team, was saying that the win for USA is a win for everybody. Saying that, because there are some people who are fighting for equality and social justice.
Nah, it can't really work with sport, because...
She was actually talking about equal pay.
No, it can't work. It's still the same. Because the amount of revenue that the male team...
Yeah.
Like, for instance, now we're having AFCON. And we had the Women's World Cup. I'm sure that in Nigeria alone, AFCON has more views as opposed to the women that is even World Cup. Now, based on the viewership, based on sponsorship, that AFCON alone, that is even just Africa, would generate more money or has a tendency to generate more money than the Women's World Cup, which is actually... So, I mean, based on the amount, you think everybody wants to run at a loss? No. If I generate, say, 20 billion...
But one question is, why do people prefer to watch male football compared to female? Or, like,
female,
we have more viewers for...
It's cheeky. Even me, as a lady, I don't really watch...
So, how do you now encourage them when you say it's cheeky? As a lady?
We know ourselves. I'm Arawal.
I understand. All right. Another issue that came up. Those who were evicted at in the house.
Big Brother.
The BB Niger. Yes.
I mean,
Avalon.
It came as a surprise, because normally Big Brother, we're not used. We know that Big Brother will say, there's eviction on the first night, but it's usually fake. Or when they evict them, they bring them back, you know, and well, maybe they'll bring this ones back too. But I mean, it was really, I think because we, the viewers, didn't have to vote. Normally, we are the ones that actually decide who stays in the house and who leaves. But this one, it was based on coins.
Well, those are the rules, and you can not just.
I don't really know, because those two people that were removed were actually people that were contributing in their own little quota. I mean,
I think Avala dances well.
Avala, not really, but at least she rocked her body on the Saturday night party. Yeah, she did. You see, Lama, now it's like me, low cut, open wig. But when they do makeup like this, it's total turnaround, come and use gang gang, and then she's endowed.
Yeah, I was going to talk about that. Oh! You know, the endowed ladies in that house. You know, and I'm sure that's what most Nigerians love to watch.
No, that's not what they like to watch.
You just
they
talked
like
about
the
it.
Entertainment. I just said.
Hold on, now.
I just said
mentioned endowed. How come that was the last thing you mentioned?
It could have been the first thing. I just said, and she's an, and
endowed.
Then he said,
anyway, it's a good thing to be endowed. I'm endowed. Are you endowed?
I'm not endowed.
All right, that's it. Thank you so much. Join us again. My name is Rotimi, and
I am Boyo. Peace out.